So recently, across the maybe 2 or 3 years, especially in Europe, we've seen an increased demand for EACs, specifically guarantees of origin. Some of that demand from the corporate side comes from the fact that RE100 companies are trying to reach their 100% target. But also backing that up is actually European legislation saying that guarantees of origin is the solution or the tracking instrument you actually need to track your renewable energy procurement in the European Union. We also see, based on that same legislation, that VPPAs or virtual PPAs are becoming more and more popular in the European market. And there may be a few years behind the US market when it comes to corporate PPAs, but it's definitely a growing interest for it. And the legislation says that it needs to open up. So there's going to be more and more of that in the European market as well. To add on to that, I will also say that European corporates and also international corporates, they're now putting more and more pressure on their supply chain to actually become green. So that's also increasing the demand for EACs internationally. In terms of products and regions where it's growing, we see that typically where there is a high industrial closeness, there is increased demand for renewables. And also along with the supply chain being engaged by these corporates, we see that their need for renewable action in these markets is going to affect demand. And we also see that in some of these markets, for example, in Southeast Asia and China and India, a lot of the supply chain is situated there. So they're also instructed or asked to become renewable. And that has also increased the demand for EACs. In Europe specifically, you see that more and more of the corporates are becoming more educated on what type of solutions they want. So they're actually going and being more specific in terms of technology, age, and what country they're actually procuring their EAC in Europe from.